ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah wa nashhadu anna sayyidana wa nabiyyana wa shafi'ana wa habibana wa maulana muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh amma ba'd a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu idha qumtum ila as-salah فاغسلوا وجوهكم وأيديكم إلى المرافق وقال تعالى والله يحب المطهرين وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من توضأ وأحسن الوضوء خرجت خطاياه من جسده حتى تخرج من تحت أظفاره أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. Dear brother and sister in Islam, today, I would like to share few ahadith and few Qur'ani ayah regarding the cleanliness. And as normally, when we talk about the cleanliness, we think cleaning our body is only considered as a cleanliness. But on top, in the Quran and saying of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we talk about the cleanliness, not only that we are clean ourselves, making wudu or making ghusl or clean our clothes, but on top, what is the more importance is the cleaning our heart, cleaning our thinking. So this both go together. When we talk about the cleaning, meaning cleaning outwardly and cleaning inwardly. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran when talking about the avoid sin, avoid evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذَرُوا ظَاهِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَبَاطِنًا. Abstain away for inwardly and outwardly sin. Inwardly and outwardly both go together. When we talk about the cleanliness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُطَّهِّرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who make themselves clean and pure. If you open the Quran, if you open the tafsir, not only when person making wudu, this consider only clean. But beside on top, on top, cleaning ourselves inwardly is more important than cleaning outward. Both go together. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the early stage, when our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got prophethood and Quran started revealing. So after 2-3 surah, third surah, we read in Surah Al-Muzzammil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking with Bilal in such a way, he say, Ya ayyuhal muddassis. In Urdu we say, oh Kali Kamri wale. In Urdu language, we translate, is a nice way, oh Kali Kamri wale. Ya ayyuhal muddassir, qum fa andir. Wake up and aware the people. وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ وَسِيَابَكَ فَطَهِّرْ. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَسِيَابَكَ فَطَهِّرْ, and purifies your self. Mufassirin explain, وَسِيَابَكَ فَطَهِّرْ, what this mean? مِنَ الْآثَامِ. Think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking with Bilawal. Is the sinless. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking with Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He say, with the any evil deed, clean yourself, purify yourself. The inwardly, outwardly go together. Inwardly and outwardly go together. In one hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whenever Jibreel alayhi wa sallam come to me, first he ordered to clean. First he ordered me to use the miswak, toothpick. The cleaning outwardly. It is inwardly also going. That is the message coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The cleaning outwardly and inwardly both go together. Both go together. And as we know, like say, purity and impurity like a light. Both cannot come together. A person is outwardly is clean, but inwardly is impure. There is some evil thought inside. So how can this go together? How can this possible? In a hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, "Man tawazza'a fa ahsana al-wudu, kharajat khatayahu min jasadihi hatta takhruja min tahti azfarihi." So outwardly, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talking here. He say, when person making wudu and he make wudu properly, fa ahsana al-wudu, well. What this mean? He say making wudu and making wudu well. In one hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, the one person make wudu and he wash his all parts once, is a must. Is must. There is no way, no choice to choose. One time washing each limb, each part is must. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when he wash second time, he get more reward. And then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, when he wash each part three times, هَذَا وُزُوءِ وَوُزُوءِ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ مِنْ قَبْلِ. This is the my wudu and before me the Prophet. So here, مَنْ تَوَزَّعَ فَأَحْسَنَ الْوُضُوء. When person make wudu, do wudu ablution, and then he do well, perfectly. What this mean? Is he making three times each part? This is the wuzu of Anbiya, wuzu of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When person care about the outwardly, only outwardly, he say, kharajat khafayahu min jasadihi hatta min tahti asfari. So all sins from his face and in his head and on his feet coming out. Even the under the nail, this all sins coming out. The outwardly is whatever we are doing, is coming out only making the wudu. Imagine, think about when person try to clean inside, so how he will be pure. In the hadith, Prophet ﷺ mentioned, when if anyone who give me about the two things. من تحت قدمي ومن تحت شفتي. Person, if anyone who guarantee me, I guarantee him about the Jannah. And what these two things? Is his tongue and private part. If person guarantee me about, he going to take care, I will guarantee him paradise. The here outward, when person speak out, is talking something about someone, he is evil, coming from inside. Not taking care about himself, doing fornication, is also coming. Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi very beautifully explained about the cleanliness. He said, purity has four stages. When we know this thing, immediately we're going to know what this means, cleanliness, inwardly and outwardly. Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi said, purity has four stages. Number one, the purification of the external organs from filth. When we clean ourselves, making wudu, taking bath, from outside everything is clean. So purity, number one. Number two, the purification of the body organs from sins and faults. Number three, the purification of the heart from evil thought and evil vices. And number four, the purification of the inner self from everything except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you understand this thing, now what I share with you hadith, about the taking care about the two things, your tongue and your private part. Inner sin, but both. In Urdu say, belazzat and lazzat. When we're talking about someone, we're not getting any benefit. Did we get any benefit? We speak out someone about the bad. We getting money, or we have any benefit? No benefit, but still the evil. And secondly, person don't care about his private part, doing fornication. He's getting benefit. He's doing sin, but he's gaining benefits. He's fulfilling his khawish. He's fulfilling his desire. The evil things, evil thought from inside. He say purification of the body organs and purification of the evil thought, evil thinking or evil saying. The both. When Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi explained inwardly any purification both ways. The person getting benefit when person drink alcohol, doing the evil things, he's not cleaning himself, he's getting benefit himself. But speaking out about the jealousy, about the hasad. One day Prophet ﷺ was talking in front of the Sahaba about the jealousy, about the hasad, about the ghibah. Afwan, about the ghibah. Prophet ﷺ was talking in front of the Sahaba. He making ghibah is haram, is not allowed. Sahaba asked, oh Prophet of Allah, if there is what we are talking, spitting on him, he is doing exactly what we are talking. Prophet ﷺ says, this called the ghibah. If you are talking, whatever you are talking, everything is there. He is doing wrong and same thing you are talking about him or about her. This called a ghibah. But if there is nothing what you are talking, is called buhtan. It's called buhtan. It's the more danger than the ghibah. And we know making a ghibah is the worst. Prophet ﷺ giving the example is not even a appropriate to share, is not even a good to talk. And what the giving example, Prophet ﷺ, person doing ghibah, making ghibah, is like Prophet ﷺ say, if person doing zina with his mom, think about this is the ghibah. What about the bahtan? What about the bahtan? See, when person drink alcohol, when person do fornication, when he realize, he raise hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is the possibility Allah can forgive. But when person doing buhtan, when person doing the ghibah, he have to do more. He ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, I did wrong. But it's not enough. You have to go to that person. I speak this and that. One, when person doing zina, fornication, that is the easy, if you comparing doing ghibah. They involve two things. Here, Imam himself. He's only doing by himself. He's not bothering someone if he's drinking. But when he's doing ghibah, bahtan, destroying the community, destroying the friendship in between. The purification, outwardly and inwardly, both is go together. Both is so important. When person make wudu, how his sins falling down, Prophet ﷺ say, the same way, if person taking care about the inward evil, then he going to get the benefit. In a hadith, Prophet ﷺ say, inna ummati yuda'auna yawm al-qiyamati ghurram muhajjaleena min athari wudu, faman istata'a minkum an yutila غُرَّتَهُ فَلْيَفْعَلْ مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. In this hadith, Prophet ﷺ mentioned that on the day of Qiyamah, on the day of Qiyamah, my ummah will, my follower will be called on the day of judgment. When, because of their wudu, his face, his hand, his leg going to be shine. It's going to be shine. And then Prophet ﷺ says, فَمَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمْ أَن يُطِيلَ غُرَّتَهُ فَلْيَفْعَلْ. If you want to do, continue doing, making wudu, think about. Prophet ﷺ didn't give even a simple example. When person take bath and he's going to be shine. Only wudu. And when person make the wudu, when person want to intend to pray salah, when person intend to reading the Quran, person making a wudu. This means clean outward firstly, and then stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or then talk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, read the Quran. Talk, speaking. When we're reading the Quran, meaning we're talking with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The outwardly cleaning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu idha kumtum ila salah fawasilu wujuhakum. O believer, when you intend to pray your salah and talking about the wudu, and they say, if you don't found the water, فَتَيَمَّمُوا سَعِيدًا طَيِّبًا فَمْسَحُوا بِوُجُوهِكُمْ وَأَيْدِيكُمْ مِنْ. And then afterwards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, if you don't found the water, make tayammum. And then Allah subhanahu, مَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيَجَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ حَرَجْ وَلَكِنْ يُرِيدُ لِيُطَهِّرَكُمْ. Allah not intending to make you in difficulties. If you don't found water, do it tayammum, this and that. Allah don't want. Or Allah don't want like saying, this time why are you making wudu? Not for difficulty. Why? وَلَكِنْ يُرِيدُ لِيُطَهِّرَكُمْ. Allah want to make you pure. Outwardly and inwardly should be a clean. Should be a clean. وَذَرُوا ظَاهِرَ الْإِسْمِ وَبَاطِنَا. Avoid outward sin and inward sin. Evil thought also avoid. Do something, apparently see this is the guna, this is the sin. Avoid that and avoid what people doesn't know, what we are thinking. This also consider bad thinking is also evil. Outwardly, inwardly. Follow the inwardly sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Follow the outwardly sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Both put together. If somebody say, I only follow sunnah inwardly, niyyah, ikhlas, intention, is enough. How can it possible? It's possible for me, what I learn, what front of my teacher, what I learn from the Quran, for me, I think is myself is hard, difficult. For other, up to them. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the inwardly, outwardly. So in this hadith, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَلَكِنْ يُرِيدُ لِيْطَهِرَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to purify. Why? Again, وَلِيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Allah wants to make his ni'mah perfect. How if we start thinking, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the wudu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the wudu. And they say cleaning, Allah wants to, I'd like to purify, and I would like to like say send my all blessing. If we start thinking, how? You say Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi say, if person only talking about the cleanliness, only wudu, and he forget about inward cleaning, say this means he doesn't know about the deen properly. What this mean cleanliness? What this mean cleanliness? He doesn't know about that. The cleaning inwardly, outwardly is so important. Say in our hadith, say cleaning outwardly, how much important? One Sahabi, Shabib ibn Abi Raw, he mentioning the his incident. He say, one day, I was praying behind the Rasulullah s.a.w. Salatul Fajr. And Prophet s.a.w. start Surah Al-Rum. Alif Lam Mim Ghalibat Al-Rum. Fi adna al-ardi wa hum min ba'di ghalabihim sayaghribun. Faltabasa. Prophet s.a.w. get confused. During the Salah, when Prophet s.a.w. was reading, they get confused. فَلَمَّا صَلَّى. When Prophet ﷺ finishes Salah, and he say, ما بال أقوام يصلون معنا لا يحسنون الطهور ما بال أقوام يصلون معنا لا يحسنون الطهور. You see, what the matter with the people who is praying with us or behind us, and they don't do, not doing wudu well? What's happened with the people? What the matter with people? They're not taking care about the wudu. They're not doing wudu properly. Imagine, think, outwardly cleaning is going to affect when Imam is standing and is in effect in his reading. Nabiullah, he is talking. What about the inwardly cleaning? If you have hasad, jealousy in our heart, if we have bad thinking in our heart, or always we are talking something wrong, or we do something wrong, so how can, is there is possibility on the day of Qiyamah, Prophet ﷺ mentioned, he said, I will know the my ummah because of their faces, they're going to shine. When the Prophet ﷺ was in the graveyard, and was say, Assalamu alaykum ya ahl al-diyar min al-mu'mineen wal-mu'minat wa inna insha'allahu bikum lahiqun. Prophet ﷺ was reading the dua and talking, say, I will see you on the day of Qiyamah. Sahaba also with them, O Prophet of Allah, you telling, you say, my friend, we are not, you say, you are my Sahaba. And Prophet ﷺ mentioned, he said, who didn't see me? And then afterwards, Sahaba asked, oh Prophet of Allah, how are you going to recognize them? It's a lengthy hadith, Prophet ﷺ mentioned, because of the wudu, their face going to be shine, their hand going to be shine. I will recognize them. When person make habit to pray salah, what he going to do, make wudu. The outwardly how is important, inwardly also important. In one day, in a long hadith, Prophet ﷺ talking about the day of Qiyamah, day of judgment, he said, I will be the first one. If from the sajda I am going to up. The hadith is sahih. From the sajda I will be come out. And then what's going, Prophet ﷺ mentioned, I will do shafa'ah, this and that. And I will recognize my ummah. The Sahaba asked, oh Prophet of Allah, on day of Qiyamah, there is the so many people. There is the Nuh alayhi salam's people, other Sahaba's people, other Prophet's people. How are you going to recognize them? In this lengthy hadith, again, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, min asari al-wudu. Ghurram muhajjilin min asari al-wudu. I'm going to recognize my ummah because of their wudu. So outwardly, taking care, what the lesson we're getting from here. Even person, who going to make wudu? Who intend to pray salah? Who intend to read the Quran? People taking shower every single day. But Prophet ﷺ never ever, if you read the ahadith, he say, we're taking shower, his face going to be shine on the day of Qiyamah. No, only for wudu. How is like, say, after wudu, all sins, outwardly sins come out. That is the really something I would like to share. One day, Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayh, among the four imam, one imam, that is the great faqih, Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayh, he was making wudu. Someone also making wudu beside. When he looked towards this person, and he see, like say, what he did is all sins falling down. In the hadith and sahih, what we learned, see falling down. After the wudu, Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi raise hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, take away this thing from me. Take away this thing from me. Ask. Oh faqih, why you ask? He say, I don't want to see someone who are making wudu beside me, and if I look them and I see his sins falling down, maybe some bad thought coming in my mind, and my inside, my inwardly cleanliness goes away. When we read the history of the Tabi'een, Tabi'i Tabi'een, forget about the Sahaba, forget about the Anbiya. If we read only history of the Tabi'i, Tabi'i Tabi'een, when we come to know how much care they used to care. One day, one Sheikh was going, and with him some people going. And we know, like before that, there is the in between the river. If they want to pass, sometimes they have to use the boat. Sometimes little but water, they have to pass something like that. Little water. One day, he was there, and they also intend to go other side. One person, they look almost passing the river. He hold one woman on his shoulder, and he is going. And from who, which sheikh, they say, look at the sheikh, look at that person. He is going with who? Must be someone. Must be someone. He's not his wife. Look like he's not his mother. Must be someone. Sheikh say, maybe your eyes is wrong. Sheikh, we are looking. It's the front of us. He's doing something wrong. He's doing something wrong. See, when they see there's something wrong going on, they try to think in a different way. Positive way, not a negative way. But today, our situation, unfortunately, Allah save us, but it's happening. Even somebody talking about some incident, they try to take negativity from there. They try to take. That's why, ba'd, you know, differences, and going, no one coming together. Here we are sitting in a small gathering. It's the small gathering. One question. My one question to everyone. How much feeling, how many brother and sister feeling? They say, I try my best to be together. Sometime what's happening when Imam is speaking, whole khutbah lesson, but there's some small point, something happening outside. Not even leaving the masjid, not even at house. And before that, discussion starts. Not like that, this and that. Negativity. No one try, hardly trying. Okay, whole topic. One good stuff we heard today. Let me try to follow. But unfortunately, like a media, what's happening? They listen, hold, they ask you. But small point, they start raising. Please start raising. So now, today's lesson, how is important to clean outwardly. We should try to clean in our inwardly. We have to avoid the jealousy. We have to avoid the riba. We have to avoid the all other evil things. If we take care about, then inshallah, time will come. We're going to see even a small gathering. Mahabbah coming, inshallah. Our health going to become. If we try. If we don't try, then how is happening all over the suffering. Maybe Allah protect us. But it's going to be happen.